Good morning students, welcome to social science class. Today we will revise some part of the first chapter in history, the French Revolution. Let's begin. Location of France. Before we read about any country and whatever happened there, we must know where that country is located. France is a West European country and its location you can easily see in this world map. Now, let's have an introduction to revolution. What is a revolution? Revolution is the sudden change in the political power and political organization. It means that, for example, if any country is being ruled by a monarch and that monarch is cruel, he is autocratic, he is not doing the welfare work for the people, people can raise their voice against the king, they can revolt against him, and they can bring about a change from monarchy to democracy. This is what we call a revolution. And same thing happened in France also. Let's see what all the causes were there for the French Revolution. First important cause, that was the political causes. The year is 1774. King Louis XVI ascended the throne. Means Louis XVI became the king in the year 1774. But this king was not a good administrator. He was an absolute monarch. Absolute monarch means what? He did whatever he liked and he did not have any control on him. Means there was no constitution to limit the power of the king. The king had unlimited power. And because of that, he misused his powers many times, and that later on led to the revolution. Next, the social causes. The society was also divided in three parts. First was the clergy, second the nobility, and third was the common people. And these groups of the society were given the name state, first state, second state, and third state. First state consisted of clergy. Clergy were the people who were associated with the church. Noble means those were the aristocratic families related to the kings and nobles. Those were the landlords having big land areas. There was actually a feudal system, means in which there were few people who were having big area of land and on which they forced the farmers to work on that land. So these were the nobles, and they led a very lavish lifestyle. And third state was of the common people. But the irony was that there was totally inequality. All the taxes were paid only by the people of the third state. And this nobility and clergy, they were exempted from paying any sort of taxes. That time there were two types of taxes. One was tithe, another was telli. Tithe was a tax that was levied by the church. Means these people had to give tax to the church also, and they had to give a tax directly to the king also. So they were under the heavy burden of taxes. And that led to the, means the rich people became more rich and poor people became more poor. And this widened the gap of the rich and poor in the French society. Then there were some economic causes also. When in 1774, when the king ascended the throne, when Louis XVI became the king, what he find that his treasury, means the money which a king should have for his day-to-day work, that enough money was not there in his treasury. And what were the reasons for it? There were mainly three reasons. First was the long years of war. France and England had war for about 100 years, and that drained away a lot of wealth of the France. And they also had fought most of the war by taking money from some other countries. Means they were having a lot of debts on them. Means lot of money they had to pay in the form of interest. The French monarch also helped the American colonies to get their freedom, because they considered Britain as their common enemy, and that's why they even helped the American colonies to get freedom from the Britishers, because the France was not successful in India. In India, they were pushed away by the Britishers. So in America, they helped the American colonies to push away the Britishers. And also, there was a big palace at Versailles, and a lot of money was spent on its maintenance also. And in such a situation, there was a failure of crops, there was drought, there was hailstones, the weather was not favorable, so there was a shortage of crops, shortage of food for the people. And this situation, when people not having food to eat, not having jobs to do, such a situation is known as the subsistence crisis. Means a person not having the basic necessities to remain alive. And all these were the economic causes that also led to the French Revolution. So, dear children, we have learned about three causes today. Thank you and have a nice day.